Hello and welcome to this session. In this session, we shall discuss the following question, and the question says that Kevin wants to investigate whether a 12-year-old child reads more than an 8-year-old child. Kevin decides to measure reading in terms of the number of books read. He surveys 90 children from each age group. He asks them how many books they have read in last 4 months. He has the following data. What conclusion does he draw? Let us move on to the solution. In this question, we are given 2 samples of size 90 of 8-year-old and 12-year-old children displaying their reading habits, and we see that for 12-year-old children we have 7 children who have not read a book in the last 4 months, 11 children have read only 1 book in the last 4 months, 16 have read 2 books, 21 have read 3 books, 19 children have read 4 books, 12 children have read 5 books and 4 children have read 6 books in the last 4 months. And similarly, for 8-year-old children, we are given that there are 20 children who have not read a book in the last 4 months, 25 have read only 1 book in the last 4 months, 21 have read 2 books, 10 have read 3 books, 8 have read 4 books, 6 children have read 5 books, and there is no child who has read 6 books in the last 4 months. Let us draw a bar diagram for both the series. First, we shall draw a bar diagram for 12-year-old children, and here is the required bar diagram for 12-year-old children, in which we have taken the number of books on the x-axis and frequency on y-axis. And here we can see that 7 children have read no book in the last 4 months, 11 children have read a book in the last 4 months, there are 16 children who have read 2 books in the last 4 months, and similarly, 21 children have read 3 books, 19 children have read 4 books in the last 4 months, 12 children have read 5 books, and there are 4 children who have read 6 books in the last 4 months. Similarly, we shall make a bar diagram for 8-year-old children, and we get the following bar graph, in which on x-axis we have represented the number of books and frequency is along the y-axis. And from the bar graph we conclude that there are 20 children who have not read a book in the last 4 months, 25 children have read only 1 book in the last 4 months, there are 21 children who have read 2 books, 10 children have read 3 books, 8 children have read 4 books, and there are 6 children who have read 5 books in the last 4 months, and there is no child who has read 6 books in the last 4 months. So here we have the required bar graph for 8-year-old children. We have chosen this bar display because there are not many different values recorded, but a large number of people were surveyed. Now we can see that mode for 12-year-old children is 3 because highest frequency is 21, which is at 3. So for 12-year-old children, mode is given as 3, and similarly we can say that For 8-year-old children, the mode is at 1 because highest frequency is 25 corresponding to 1. So, for 8-year-old children, mode is 1. So, we can say that results of 12-year-old children are higher than 8-year-old children. And we also see that the data values for 12-year-old children are widely spread, but mostly between 2 to 4, and most of the data values for 8-year-old children are clustered between 0 to 2. So, he concludes that twelve-year-old children generally read more than 8-year-old children. This is the required answer. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.